Hello students, today we are going to start with quantum numbers. Quantum numbers are used in order to find out the exact position of a particular electron in an atom. There are four set of quantum numbers. The first is principal quantum number, second one is azimuthal quantum number, third one is magnetic quantum number, and fourth one is spin quantum number. We will discuss about these all four quantum numbers one by one. Let's start with the principal quantum number. Principal quantum number is represented by m, and it basically represents the energy level, that means orbital. We know that in an atom, this is the nucleus, and electrons revolve around the nucleus in some orbits, and we know that energy of a particular orbit is constant. That is why they are also known as energy levels. The first energy level, second energy level, third energy level, and so on. These energy levels are represented by principal quantum number. For first energy level or first orbital, n is equal to 1. For second one, it is n is equal to 2. For third one, it is n is equal to 3. That means if we say about n is equal to 4, it represents the fourth orbit or fourth energy level. So the first thing which is represented by the principal quantum number is energy level. The second thing is radius. Obviously, as the energy level increases or the orbital increases, the radius also increases. That means radius means the distance between orbital and the nucleus. This distance or radius increases with increasing energy levels as the size increases. So the second thing which it represents is radius or size. The next thing is distance of the electron from the nucleus. It is quite obvious that if the radius is increasing, the distance of electron present in that energy level will also increase. That is, distance from nucleus to that electron will increase with increasing energy level. The electron which is present in first energy level will be closer to the nucleus. The one which is present in second will be at longer distance as compared to the one which is present in first orbital. So the distance from the nucleus of an electron increases with increasing quantum number, principal quantum number. The next thing is velocity of electron. We know that velocity of an electron in a particular atom is inversely proportional to the quantum number, principal quantum number. That means the electron which is present in third energy level will have a lesser velocity as compared to that one which is present in second energy level. So the velocity of a particular electron also depends on the principal quantum number. Principal quantum number represents four things. First is energy level, second is radius or size of the orbital, third one is distance of the electron from the nucleus, fourth one is energy of electron, and it also represents velocity of the electron present in particular orbit. The next thing is number of orbitals present in a particular shell or energy level can be represented by n squared. Similarly, number of electrons present in an atom is represented by 2n squared. This is known as Bohr-Mori rule. N square represents the number of orbitals. Every energy level or subshell has some particular number of orbitals present in it. Just like n is equal to 1, if we go through this formula, n is equal to 1 will have how many orbitals? Yes, 1 square, n square. That is only 1. First energy level will have 1 orbital. Similarly, second energy level will have 4 orbitals, and so on. Now, the number of electrons present in a particular energy level is calculated using the formula 2n squared. That means if we talk about first orbital, that is n is first energy level, that is n is equal to 1, there will be 2n squared. That means 2 into 1 square, that means 2 electrons. Only 2 electrons are present in first energy level. For first energy level, number of orbitals is 1 and number of electrons are 2. And we know that if we write electronic configuration, we always write in this form 2, 8, 8, and so on. That means there are always two electrons present in first orbital and which are also protected by this rule, which is known as Bohr-Mari rule, according to which the number of orbitals will be n square while the number of electrons will be 2n square. Okay, now let's move to our second quantum number, which is azimuthal quantum number, and this is denoted by L. Now what does it indicate? It indicates the subshell of electron. We are talking about subshell or orbital. It denotes subshell. Azimuthal quantum number, or that is principal quantum number, indicates shell. Azimuthal quantum number indicates subshells. Now subshells, first thing it indicates subshell, second thing it indicates the shape of orbital. What will be the shape? Shape of orbital may be spherical, it may be dumbbell shape, it may be double dumbbell shape, or it may be complex. So what will be the shape of a particular orbital? This is predicted using its azimuthal quantum number, and its value may vary from 0 to n minus 1. For a particular value of n, the value of L, that is azimuthal quantum number, varies from 0 to n minus 1. 0 to n minus 1. That is, if we say for n is equal to 1, we will have how many values of L? It will be only 1, that is 0. For n is equal to 2, we will have three values. No, the first one will be again 0, the next is 1. For n is equal to 3, we have 0, 1 and 2, 3 values. So the value of azimuthal quantum number depends on the value of principal quantum number, which varies from 0 to n minus 1. If we are talking about the fifth, if the value of principal quantum number is 5, then the values, the possible values of azimuthal quantum number will be 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4, that means 1 less than n. And for 6, n is equal to 6, it will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For n is equal to 3, it will be 0, 1 and 2. For n is equal to 2, it will be 0 and 1. So the value of L starts from 0 to n minus 1. Again, the value of L may be 0, 1, 2, 3 depending on the value of n. So 0 means s orbital, 1 means p orbital, 2 means d orbital, and L is equal to 3 means f orbital. And the shape of s orbital is spherical, that of p orbital is dumbbell, d orbital is double dumbbell, and that of f is complex. So in this way azimuthal quantum number indicates the shape of a particular orbital. Next thing which it denotes is the number of orbitals. L is equal to 3. L is equal to 3 means f orbital. Sorry, f subshell. And for f subshell, according to this formula, there will be 2 into 3 plus 1, a total of 7 orbitals present. There will be a total of 7 orbitals for f subshell using this formula. For L is equal to 0, there will be only 1 orbital. For L is equal to 2, using this formula, there will be 3 orbitals. For L is equal to 3, using this formula, there will be a total of 7 orbitals. So the number of orbitals for any particular subshell, which is represented by a value of L, that was 0, 1, 2, 3, or SPD, can be calculated using this formula. The next thing is angular momentum. its orbital angular momentum. This can also be calculated using azimuthal Cantor number, and the value of orbital angular momentum will be under root L L plus 1 into H upon 2 pi. H is, yes, Planck constant, and where L is azimuthal Cantor number. So these six things are indicated by azimuthal Cantor number. The first one was subshell of electron, second thing was shape of orbital, and the value varies from 0 to n minus 1. For 0, the 0 indicates the S subshell, 1 indicates P subshell, 2 indicates B subshell, 3 indicates F subshell, and the shape of S subshell is spherical, that of P is dumbbell, that of B is double dumbbell, and that of F is complex. And the number of orbitals present in a particular subshell can be calculated using this formula, that is 2L plus 1, which is also equal to M. M is our next quantum number, that is magnetic quantum number. So but this was the number of orbital 2L plus 1. The next thing which can be calculated using this is angular quantum number, angular momentum, which is L bracket L plus 1 over under root H upon 2 pi. Our next quantum number is magnetic quantum number. Magnetic quantum numbers give us information about orientation of an orbit, that means it is oriented in this way or this way or this way, on which axis, x, y, z. It gives us information about the orientation of a particular orbit, particular orbital. It varies from minus L to plus L, that means for L is equal to 0, there is only one value, 0. That is why 0 represents S orbit, and the shape of S is spherical. For spherical, there is only one orientation. We cannot change its orientation, that's why it has only one orientation, and the value of M is only 1, that is 0. Now, next thing, for L is equal to 1, that is P orbital, the value of M will be minus 1, 0 and 1. That is minus L to plus L. Three possible orientations are possible for P subshell, and we know that the shape of P is dumbbell. It may be like this, it may be like, that is, it may be like this, or it may be like this. These three orientations are possible for P subshell, and that is why the value of M is 3, minus 1 to plus L. Minus L to plus L. So magnetic Cantor number tells us about the orientation of orbital, and it varies from minus L to plus L. That is, if the value of L was 3, then the corresponding values of for M will be minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2 and 3. A total of 2L plus 1 values. The next one is spin quantum number. It gives us it is represented by S, and it gives us information about the spin of electrons. Spin means rotation about its axis. It will be clockwise or anti-clockwise. If it is clockwise, it is represented by plus 1 by 2, and if it is anti-clockwise, it is represented by minus 1 by 2. Again, spin angular momentum can be calculated using this quantum number, and this will be under root S, S plus 1 into H upon 2 pi, where S is again spin quantum number and H is, yes, Planck constant. So these were the four quantum numbers. Let's try to understand these all using some examples. Let's find out all the quantum possible quantum numbers for an electron present in 3D orbital. An electron which is present in 3D orbital, we have to calculate all the four quantum numbers. Now, first of all, the number represents principal quantum number. So, n will be 3. First, the number which is written in front of orbital represents principal quantum number. So for this, an electron which is present in 3D orbit, n is will be 3. Next thing is L. This D represents L. An orbital is represented in this way by the combination of N and L, combination of principal quantum number N is the neutral quantum number and the number of electrons represented here. So N is 3 here, where L is D. D means 2. So the value of L will be 2. The next quantum number is M. We know that for a given value of L, the values of M starts from minus L to plus L. That means here minus, here L is 2, so it will be minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1 and 2. These are the 5 possible values of M. The next is spin quantum number. The value of spin quantum numbers are only 2, minus 1 by 2 or plus 1 by 2. So these are the value, possible values for 4 quantum numbers for an electron which is projected in 3D orbit. Similarly, if we talk about an electron which is present in five s orbit, the value of N will be, if we compare this with this, 5. The value of L is s, s means 0, will be 0. For L is equal to 0, there will be values of M starting from minus L to plus L, and minus N plus 0 is meaningless, so we'll write only 0. The value of M will be 0, and again the value of L, s is always fixed, plus 1 by 2 or minus 1 by 2. So these are the values of quantum numbers possible for an electron which is present in 5s orbital. Similarly, let's see another thing. N is equal to 4. N is equal to 2. N is equal to 5. And S is equal to minus 1 by 2. If this combination of quantum numbers possible, let's have a look. N is equal to 4 represents 4th energy level. L is equal to 2 is possible because 4, a particular value of N, that is, which is N is equal to 4 here, the possible values of L are 0, 1, 2, and 3, that is 0 to n minus 1. So these 4 are the possible values of L for given for n is equal to 4 and 2. So we can see here that 2 is possible. So this 2 combination of n and l is possible, which represents n what? 4, and s means 2 means d. That means it is, we are talking about here 4d orbital. The next is M is equal to 4, M is equal to 5. Now here the value of L is 2, so value of M will be from minus L to plus L. That means the value of M for L is equal to 2 will be either minus 1, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, or plus 2. These are the only possible values of N for L is equal to 2. But the given value is N is equal to 5, which is not present in this list. This is not possible. M is equal to 5 is not possible for L is equal to 2, because the only possible values for L is equal to 2 should be in between minus L to plus L, that means from minus 2 to plus 2. The range includes minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1 and 2. It does not include the value of 5. So this combination is not possible. This is not a possible combination. Orbital let's say 5s, and they will ask for, you know, they will ask you to calculate all the possible quantum values of quantum numbers which we discussed in previous example, or they will ask this type of problem in which they will give you a set of quantum numbers and they will ask them which one of the following is possible or which one of the following combination of the quantum numbers is not possible. I hope these quantum numbers are clear to you. These are very important by exam point. We discussed about four sets of quantum numbers: principal quantum number, isomorphic quantum number, magnetic quantum number, and spin quantum number. Go through these quantum numbers number of times because these are very important by exam point. Thank you.